All right, Libras, welcome to your May of 2016 Sidereal Astrology Forecast. I'm Athan, and this is for Sidereal. If you are new to the channel, be sure to check out the link because the signs are different. All right, Libra, so we're going to look at this month in terms of the overall energies. If you want to get more specific with this, do check out your weeklies for this month, as I'll go into more of the specific aspects of this. But we're going to look at the new and full moon, of course. We've got some planets changing sign, of course. Jupiter going direct, which is quite nice. Mercury going direct this month. And Jupiter squaring up to Saturn for the last and final time, which has been about this integration of what's possible in life. And for you, in terms of your ideals, your visions for the future, which has been that Jupiter in that 11th house. So let's go and start by looking at where everything is at the beginning of the month. The Sun, that Mercury retrograde, and Venus are all in your 7th house of Aries. So there's a lot of attention, especially this first half of the month, in your chart involving relationships, one-to-one connections, partnerships. And so with the Sun here, you can really be gaining energy through these interactions, through your relationships this month. You're probably learning quite a bit about it because that Mercury retrograde is suggesting that there are things that may be malleable, it might be coming into the picture, shifting and changing. You might just be reflecting on it, and that's really good. That's what you want to do during the Mercury retrograde, is try new things, be malleable, and reflect in that area. But it is going to be an area of new beginnings for you, because on the 6th, we've got this new moon. And with your ruler in that 7th house too, you guys can really be enjoying those one-to-one connections. Now, in terms of these new beginnings, it's a very supportive new moon on the 6th, and it's going to be forming a kite in the sky, which is forming a lot of easy and supportive aspects. So the big significance with this is that this is both in the short term of relationships that you can set intentions with. The new moon is a bit more of a reflective time, so it's a good time to go within, see where you want to shift things, change your perspective on relationships, maybe cultivate more of them in your life, new and existing ones. And that's both in the short term of the next 30 days, but also in the next 6 months, the long term, which is this solar cycle. So it's a great area for you to set intentions. And I feel like too, with a lot of this focus on your relationships, there's this new you coming out from all of this. It's interesting because that new moon is conjoining up to Venus. So it's suggesting there's a new you, a new self-image from all of this. So it might be from that perspective on other, that maybe you're learning more about yourself, and there's this new you that's really coming out into the forefront as the month unfolds. Now on the 9th, we've got Jupiter going station direct. Finally, Jupiter has been retrograde for about the past 5 months, which is normal. So during this time, a lot of the opportunities that Jupiter usually helps us see is a bit more on the internal level. It's not so much in the external. And so this has been opportunities for you to cultivate your ideals, your visions for the future, your hopes, your wishes, and for some of you, maybe even groups and community things. But for the past 5 months, it's been more in the internal level, a bit more reflective in that sense. But now with Jupiter going direct, I think you can see more of those opportunities out into the outward environment in which you can cultivate and take action on, especially later in the month once Jupiter gains that momentum moving forward. Now, on the 14th and 19th, we've got the Sun and then Venus shifting into Taurus. So there is this definitive shift the second half of the month. It's still going to be very much about relationships, I feel, for you. But the second half, it might be getting deeper in relationships. It might be getting into intimacy, right, and vulnerability in relationships and forming those deep bonds. But this, of course, all starts with self. And so with this shift, I think you're just going to be more focused on the deeper aspects of life. What is really meaningful to you? These kinds of things. And through that, you're gaining that awareness, you're gaining that energy. And especially on the 19th, once your ruler Venus goes in there, you can really enjoy those deep connections and really see this deeper you that might be coming out, or that you're understanding more, or whatever it might be. But with all that still going on, Mercury's still there retrograde in your 7th, and so you'll probably be re-examining, rehashing, and changing around that area of relationships for you, while things are probably focused on more about meaning and depth and truth for you. So I feel like it is a bit of a combination of both, but of course, it all starts with self in that sense. Now on the 21st, we have a full moon, which is going to be in your sign, right on the cusp between your sign and Scorpio. So you guys are at the 6 month checkpoint of what started with you, with new things in your life, with your goals, your drives, your ambitions, which was the new moon 6 months from now or ago. So it's a culmination now, and you guys can really be seeing this month, I think, who you are, what your goals are, what your ambitions are, a lot of this illumination of self. And so with that, it can be quite motivating, because this first half of the month, Mars has been in Scorpio retrograde. So you guys have been re-examining your values in life, you know, this first half. But once this full moon occurs on the 21st, around there and onward, there's a bit more of this awareness of self, yet still reflective, because Mars is going to go back into Libra. So you guys are, Mars in your first house is okay, you guys are understanding more about this stuff, but it's about trying it out. It's about trying new things, being adaptive, again, with all retrogrades there. But still asserting yourself, taking action, setting intentions, I think is fantastic with this full moon, because you get this kind of status check point, you know, 6 month, half of the year time period where you can see how your goals are going, you know, how the things that are important to you are going and what you can do to cultivate them and move them forward. Now that might be also involving your values, because it is right on the cusp between your first and your second. So specifically with your values in life might be the material values, these things, your finances, your sense of security and all of this. Good time to see that, be aware of it, and again, move forward with it in this halfway checkpoint. Now on the 22nd, Mercury goes direct. So a lot of the things that I think you have been reflecting on with relationships up to this point, you'll probably start to see moving forward. And so once Mercury gains his momentum going into June, there's a lot of this insight that you've had that can be implemented with one-to-one connections. And if you feel like this month that things are just kind of, you know, being rehashed in that area, this is when I think you can expect, at least by the early part of next month of June, these things starting to move forward for you, especially in terms of what you've learned about relationships. Now on the 26th, Jupiter squares up to Saturn. This is the last major aspect of the month, and this is the last time this has happened. So it's this sort of ending, final culmination of this hard work and discipline that I think we've all been putting into in our lives for what's possible. And this is specifically with your values. Saturn has been in your second house, so it has been a very important time for you to really take seriously your values, your finances, your material security, and more fundamentally, your sense of self-worth and your self-value and your self-reliance, working hard so you can have that stronger sense of self-reliance in your life and understanding more about your natural gifts, your natural abilities, and how to be more grateful for what you have in life, although it does take hard work to cultivate these things. So with all of that hard work there and patience and persistence there, it's directly supporting these possible things that are expanding for your ideals or your group matters with Jupiter in that 11th house. So it's good to work on it, to concretize it, also taking around the 26th your ideals seriously. What you can do to be patient and persistent with those, I think is excellent, as well as anything community related. All right, Libra, so have a fantastic month. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.